Well, that sucks. He wants all of the land and 22 ducats. I'm willing to do that, actually. Why? Because we still have cores. And I want to get my union over Morocco. The other option is we could make this a long-term war. We could keep this war going for a long time. Because he's never going to get our capital in Ireland. And if we make it a long-term war, he might get involved in other wars. Just like France is getting involved in a bunch of other wars right now. Not sure if want do. The problem is Algeria is about to lose his army here. I mean, that's... If that happens, then I don't think we're going to be able to get our union over Morocco. Oh, he already has an heir? You're kidding me. He already has an heir. Shit. So he just came of age and he already has an heir. Well, that sucks. There's no way I'm going to get a union if he already has a frickin' heir. Yeah, Algeria is going to lose his whole army here. This is not good for us. Man, I really wish we... Oh, look at this. Now the Ottomans want an alliance all of a sudden. Yes. Holy shit. Can you please come help? Why did you suddenly go friendly? Suddenly, Ottomans friendly. What? I wish he would have done that sooner. We could have had his help against... That would have made a huge difference. That would have made an amazing difference. I wonder why he suddenly went friendly. Who knows? The AI is extremely... hard to predict when it comes to their attitude. You're saying just offer him that one province and see if he'll peace out? I can't even click it for some reason. Oh, I have to go this way. Yeah. I mean, at this point, it doesn't matter because we're not getting our union over Morocco, and that makes me very sad in my pants. Goodbye, Algerian army. You used to be somebody. Now you're gone. Yep, that's another 5% war score, because the Algerian army was trashed. Alright, let's ferry these dudes home. Or we could ferry them down here, but we can't even outnumber that. We can't fight them if we can't outnumber that. So yeah, for some reason, we can completely annex... Brittany, but we cannot vassalize them outright. That makes no sense at all. I don't know how that's supposed to work. I'd be tempted to do that, but I'm not sure that really helps us, you know? That would get rid of all of our war score that we have. I mean, the only positive war score we have is sieging that stuff from Brittany. We have 8 war exhaustion. Algiers is going to peace out soon, and when Algiers pieces out, then who knows what'll happen. Alright, yeah. We'll peace out. Goodbye, Brittany. Now let's see if we can get out of the war with Castile. Before Algeria gets too tiny. I mean, he will do this. He will let me give him all of my land down here, and give him all my money that I don't have. I would prefer not to give him anything, but I'm not sure I can do that. Yeah, he's interested in getting stuff. He wants stuff. Portugal wants stuff too. Yeah, now we have border friction with France, but that'll be short-lived. Right now, Tunisia is getting invaded. I mean, there's not much I can do here. If France wasn't so busy with two other wars, I think France would be interested in declaring war on Castile. Or maybe Aragon would be interested in declaring war on Castile. But as it stands, Castile is having no trouble and nobody's going to bother them. People are just leaving Castile alone. How much more will the war score climb? Let's check. It's going to go up another 17 points just for owning Grenada. And then as he sieges up all of this land and defeats armies over here in Tunisia, his war score will increase. Whereas our war score cannot really increase. I mean, I guess we could try a blockade. We could suicide our navy down here and try to blockade a little bit. But most likely our navy would just get destroyed. Yeah, I think at this point we just have to give this stuff up. And I hate to do that, but I really hate to do that. But it means we can ignore Castile for a while and focus on other stuff. I hate this. I really hate this. There goes all of our land. My goodness. And I still can't claim... What? Oh, right. I need to release these guys. Before I release, let me go ahead and start the annexation of Connacht. And then we'll release Brittany. Speed up. Yes, we have reconquest on Castile. And we took out two massive loans. Ugh. Actually, we cannot annex because we have war exhaustion that makes it impossible. Wow. There we go. It'll take 32 years to annex. Wow. 32 years to annex just a small little two-province vassal. Even if we lower maintenance all the way, you're still looking at like no income at all. How the hell are we supposed to make any money? I need to delete some troops. Yeah, we'll delete some troops. There we go. 0.6 ducats a month. Now we're talking. Okay, release. And now we can't annex. We can no longer annex Connacht because they are now larger than we are. This is so stupid. Oh man, we're only a one province minor now, so we can't annex anyone. What in the world? Oh, there we go. So now the annexation will finish in 151 years. That's right, 1613 is when we can annex Connacht. And we're still losing money. How the hell are we still losing money? Oh, because we're not using our trade ships. Right. Okay, now we're making money. Can I get a statesman? There is a statesman, but I need 18 ducats before I can hire him. And we wouldn't be able to keep him very long, but I'm desperate to get a statesman right now. He will instantly make this integration a lot easier. Wow. Well, goodbye, Grenada. Goodbye. Oh. And we got very unlucky that Morocco came... He came to the throne at 15 and he already had an heir. That's very unlucky. Piety. Sure, give me all the piety, baby. Very, very unlucky. .07 a month. Wow. At least our war exhaustion's gone. Put our stability up, shall we? Accept cultural shifts. We can make Irish our primary culture. I don't think so. Enemy of enemy, Morocco. Protect against the Mamelukes. 32 troops. Yeah, that's not going to happen. My goodness. You know what? Screw Tyrone. I want to make sure the Ottomans keep their alliance with us. Keep them nice and happy. And a royal marriage, of course, would be good. Wow. Well, we'll save up 32 ducats. We'll buy that statesman. As much as I would love to just take loans to do it, it would take way too many loans. And then our income would be worse. Well, welcome to Irish Grenada. This feels like, you know, Luck of the Irish LP now. Except we have Tunisia as a vassal. The only difference. Oh, man. Can't believe he came to age with a frickin' heir. Who the hell comes to age at 15 with an heir? That's not cool. If we had been able to start this annexation before the war, literally the day before Castile declared war, we would be at like 50 or 70% by now, because we had four provinces at the time. Would have been much faster. Oh well. Scotland declared war on England, now we're talking. So, England now has two separate wars, one with France and one with Scotland. The one with France, they could win or lose, it doesn't matter. But the one with Scotland, that's interesting. Where is Scotland's army? Well, there we are, England and Scotland, they both have 12k. The main difference is England has a ton of manpower and Scotland does not. I wonder why the Ottomans suddenly went friendly with us. I mean, that was just out of the blue, suddenly friends, you know? I'm glad I checked, but it was very surprising. Looks like they lost the initial battle. Alright, yeah, keep relations up with Francie Pants. I really want to get an alliance with France. I really, really do. Because he would probably help me in an offensive war against Castile. To go get my land back, he would definitely help in an offensive war. And we almost have enough money. Oh yeah, we almost have enough money. There we go. Now we're talking. Okay, he's only 35, so he'll live a long time. We're still making a tiny bit of money. And yeah, he makes it so we'll integrate in 17 years instead of 160. I mean, that's a huge difference, isn't it? You know what would also help integrate faster is if we hadn't changed dynasties. When our king died, we had no heir. And that means you either become a union, a lesser partner in a union, or you change your dynasty. And in our case, we changed our dynasty. And when you change your dynasty, your legitimacy goes down to 20. And 20 legitimacy means you have negative public, or what's it called, diplomatic reputation. See, negative 1.2 from legitimacy. But getting a statesman will counter that because he adds to the reputation. And the reputation is directly responsible for how fast you integrate. Anywho, tech up time, sounds good. Oh yeah, we would have been almost done annexing. In fact, we might have finished annexing them during that war if we had been able to hit it the day before he declared on us, but we didn't. We had to wait until Feb 5th or whatever the day was. No, what's going on, Tunisia? What is this? Berber Patriots. Oh, that's no good. Yeah, that really is no good. I killed my transport ships. Well, I guess I have to build some more transport ships. Because I destroyed them. Maxed relations with France again. Wow, we're at 8 out of 4. Holy crap. We have 4 vassals. Have our marriage with Morocco, yeah. Alliances, and then France. Yeah, that's definitely 8. 48 out of 68. You know what? I think I am going to guarantee them. I want France to try to like me. I mean, we already have military access, so a guarantee doesn't really affect us. It doesn't add another relationship or anything. Okay, get relations up with Tyrone. I have to get there before they finish sieging this shit. Or at least before it flips over to Algeria. Oh god, they got the walls busted and everything. Ferk! Ferk! France is somehow losing his war against England. I mean, as soon as he finishes sieging Calais, he should be fine. It's a reconquest of Calais, right? Yeah, so as soon as he finishes sieging Calais, he'll have tons of war score in his favor. National institutions. Lose a bunch of points or lose stability. I don't like either option. Okay, we have one transport. We actually cannot afford a second transport. It costs, what, 12 ducats for a transport? Yeah, 12 ducats. I ain't got 12 ducats. Oh my goodness. Well, bring a dude. We'll do our best. It's only 3 guys. It's only 3 guys, and Tunisia cannot handle it on their own. That's just sad. It's also sad that I have to ferry over 1 troop at a time. That's amazingly sad. I mean, we take attrition down here now, because we don't have any lands down here anymore. Alright, go pick up more dudes. But, yeah, what do we have? We have 2 cav. Oh, Tunisia deleted one of his soldiers. What the fuck, Tunisia? He had 2 guys, now he only has 1. Oh, shit. Well, let's see if we can pick up a couple more guys before it flips. Ugh. God, this sucks. This really sucks. Okay, there we go. Let me get a regular soldier this time. Isn't this amazingly stupid? I only have 8 ducats, so I can't even afford a second ship yet. Why would Tunisia delete his guy? We need to kill these rebels. And he's like, well, I can't afford my dudes anymore, so I guess I better delete them. Oh, crap. It's gonna flip. I don't think we can get there in time. And now we're losing money for some damn reason. What changed? Why are we suddenly losing money? Maybe our trade ship's docked up or something. Alright, we did make it, but that's only... yeah. And he's not even following me. It's fucking pussy Tunisia is not even following me. There's no way I can kill them if you don't follow me, dude. I got a great general. You know what? I'm gonna try anyway. Because fuck you, Tunisia. You're an idiot. I have to try. Tunisia, why are you not following me? Oh, and I'm not even funding my units. So I just lost this army because I'm not funding my units. God, I'm dumb. Did you know how dumb I am? Let me pause. Can I get you home? Okay, we didn't lose the units. Thank God. Fund the fucking troops. Oh my God, I'm so dumb. I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot.